Art has always been the most intimate part about me, which is why it took me so long to share it with the rest of the world. Before September of 2017, I considered myself pretty patriotic. I wore the American flag on most of my clothing. I wanted to live that American dream. Heck, you might even say some of my ideals were quite conservative. But on September of 2017, all that changed. I was visiting the White House. I've always wanted to go to Washington, D.C. And as I'm standing in front of the White House, I get a notification from the news, which is very odd because I literally never get notifications from the news. But this one caught my eye because they announced that they wanted to dissolve the Deferred Action Care Act, also known as DACA. I was under DACA. That night I got really drunk. I went up in front of the White House and started dancing, and I cursed at it until I started tripping over the railings and security approached me, so I decided to step away. I walked towards the Lincoln Memorial because that was my favorite monument. And like a baby, I cried. The next day, I went to New York. And that night, I also got really drunk. Coincidentally, we bumped into a friend from back home. She was there for modeling. And that night, we talked about art. And she told me maybe it was time I shared it publicly. And I definitely considered it. The next day, I was extremely hungover and I felt like shit. We went to Liberty Island, and as I stood there and looked at the Statue of Liberty, I thought about what America really meant. And then at that moment, it hit me. I've always loved America, but America has never loved me. In fact, I remember reading the comments, and I knew a lot of Americans wanted me dead. In fact, they wanted me in a cage. When I got back home, I painted this, and it was the first time in a long time that I had poured my emotions into an art piece. On July 2018, I was angry because they started the separations of families. It was constantly on my mind because I thought that could be me. That could be my mother, my brothers, my cousins, everybody that I love could be in there. So I painted this. In retrospection, I wasn't very happy with it because it was made out of anger. And that's okay. That's what art does. The problem is that they turned this issue into a political debate, into a political game about blue and red, about Obama did this and Trump did that. We can debate and discuss about border safety policies, but we cannot debate and discuss about children being separated from their parents without any plan on getting them back together. We cannot debate about children representing themselves in court at age 5. We cannot debate about staff sexually assaulting all these children and people in these facilities without any repercussions at all. We cannot debate about thousands of children disappearing without a trace from these concentration camps. Which is why I made it my duty to make a painting that didn't pick sides. It wasn't about blue or red. It was about humanity. And I struggled, and it weighed on me, and I couldn't think of anything. And one day I was making this piece, which is a mural. And during Christmas time, I couldn't stop thinking about these kids, about these families who had to spend their holidays in these facilities. And at night when I went to sleep, I had a dream of a little girl inside a cage and a butterfly flying in to say hello, because monarch butterflies migrate. all throughout the Americas. Just like us. We are the monarch butterflies. And then, I had the idea. But I couldn't start it. I felt like I wasn't good enough. I needed time to get better. I needed time to get to a point where I felt like I was ready emotionally and artistically. And when the lockdown happened, it gave me a chance to heal, to rest, after spending a year working in a full-time job and also full-time in my art career and as a community organizer. 3 months later, I was ready. Thank you. And when I was done, for the first time in my life, I did not care if anybody else liked it. I liked it. And for the first time in my life, I felt like an artist. I was afraid of my creative side. I was afraid of where it would lead me. I was afraid that at the end of that tunnel, I'd bump into suicide. But this whole time, art healed me. It freed me. It challenged me to grow as a human being. And this was the hardest painting I've ever done, because I was in the crossroads of my life emotionally, and this painting was heartbreaking. It was really hard to make, not so much for technicalities, but because of what it was trying to say. And this thing, I know, it has over 60,000 shares. And I got the craziest support from complete strangers that felt a connection with the most personal thing I've ever created in my life. People linked it to the hashtag #SaveOurChildren. And for the longest time, I felt like Save Our Children just meant save white children, because nobody gave a fuck about those kids in cages or about those black kids who were murdered for being black. So this gave me a little hope. And to go back to the beginning, where I said that I loved America, but America didn't love me, I still love America, because I see the potential in it, in this melting pot. I also realize that it's more patriotic to understand that there's problems in a country, but to want better for it, than to act like it's perfect and hate anybody who thinks otherwise. So thank you for watching. I really appreciate your support. Take care of yourselves. Hasta luego.